Photoelectric effect introduced firm evidence of a particle nature of light. There are some phenomena like interference, diffraction, polarization, which could be explained by considering only wave nature of light. But to explain the photoelectric effect, particle nature has to be considered. It shows the light exhibits a dual nature. De Broglie just took the same idea. He said if dual nature exists for light, the dual nature must exist for all type of matter. Because the nature is symmetric, if one phenomenon is applicable to certain type of matter, the same phenomenon should be applicable to all type of matter. And he stated his hypothesis as there is a wave associated with every moving particle moving with velocity v, and the wavelength of this wave is given by lambda is equal to h upon p, that is h upon mv, where m is mass of the particle, v is velocity with which the particle is moving, and h is Planck's constant. So according to de Broglie hypothesis, every moving particle has a wave associated with it. This is the first part, and wavelength of this wave is given by lambda is equal to h upon p. This is the second part of the hypothesis. Why it is called as hypothesis? Because the firm evidence was not available. It is just a proposed explanation made on the basis of some limited evidence as a starting point for further investigation. De Broglie just said, if wave particle duality exists for light, then wave particle duality must exist for all type of particles. So there should be a wave associated with electron also. There should be a wave associated with any other particle which is moving with certain velocity v, and wavelength of that wave should be lambda equal to h upon p. So this is what de Broglie hypothesis says. De Broglie relation can be supported by using Planck's theory and Einstein's theory. Energy of a photon according to Planck's theory is given by E is equal to h nu, where h is Planck's constant and nu is frequency of radiation. And if we consider photon as a particle of mass m, then its energy as per Einstein's mass energy relation is given as E is equal to mc square. So both h nu and mc square are energies of the photon, and therefore we can equate them. H nu equal to mc square. Let us call this as equation number 3. The photon is traveling with velocity c in free space. So velocity of light is c. So photon will travel with velocity equal to c. So its momentum p is given by m into c. So momentum of photon is equal to m into c. Let us call this as equation number 4. De Broglie supported his hypothesis by using Planck's relation E is equal to h nu and Einstein's mass energy relation E is equal to mc square. So h nu and mc square both are energies of the photon. So h nu can be equated with mc square. The momentum of the photon p is equal to mc mass into velocity. So we can divide equation number 3 by equation number 4. So h nu by p is equal to mc square upon mc. So 1c will get cancelled here, mm will get cancelled with each other. So h nu upon p is equal to c, or h upon p is equal to c by nu, and c by nu is nothing but lambda, the wavelength. So lambda is equal to h upon p. So de Broglie just said if E is equal to h nu, that is Planck's relation is correct, and E is equal to mc square, that is Einstein's relation is correct, then lambda must be equal to h upon p. So this lambda equal to h upon p was obtained for photon. De Broglie said that if it is true for photon, it must be true for all the type of particles like electrons, neutrons and any other particle. So this is a simple explanation given in support of de Broglie relation lambda equal to h upon p. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, then please subscribe to the channel so that you will get timely intimation of new videos uploaded to the channel. Thank you very much.